Okay, folks, we're gonna have a little bit of fun playing something else. I used the Lochnar set to help this guy level this quick, and it's gonna have a little fun. And while I'm doing that, I want to talk about something here, and it relates to games and movies and everything else, and it's about history. Okay, you know, there's a certain group of people that, at least in my opinion, they sit there and they watch their rival political side, and then when they do something silly, they rage on it. Okay? They never do anything about it. They never solve the problem. They never, you know, like let's play what if for a minute. Let's say Star Wars is going so stupid nobody wants to watch it no more. Well, that's what people will do. They'll not watch it. These people keep watching it to keep reporting on the stupid shit that would then keep, you know, whatever. You go and you give them a whole bunch of solutions. Okay, so if you don't like what Hollywood's doing, well, what are you going to do? You got to make your own entertainment. You got to get with people that are being creative about their entertainment and support them. Okay? Doesn't mean me specifically. It means all kinds of different people. Right? Like, and comic books? I'm sorry, everybody. Comics are dead. Okay? They really are. It costs pennies to distribute something by a digital a medium. Okay? You want somebody to pay $20 for pieces of paper that come from a tree when you got the tree huggers bugging you about that. And what? You want to then charge $10 for a digital copy? I mean, you're ripping people off. And eventually, these people that have all this money that are doing this, they won't have it anymore. They just won't. They're just... Yeah. So, it's like, you know... And besides, I can make up stories and do animations and movies and mess with stuff in the Unreal Engine and do something that looks far more professional. Like, holy balls. You know? It's all negative on that side, right? And this is why I'll be that guy for us that stands up and says, don't bring your politics into my video games. Just don't do it. Stop. Go away. Right? Now, you can do things like that if it's done properly. You don't shove it at people. Okay? And what you gotta do, if you're telling a story about something political, show both sides how they think they were right. Okay? And that will make it a more convincing thing for the audience to make up its own bloody mind. And if you're more leaning to one side or the other, you obviously give that a little bias, and you will show a better way. But anyway, that's how you do that without slamming it into people's brains, okay? And the fact is, artificial intelligence is now starting to do voiceover stuff, okay? And they're getting to the point where we won't need voice actors. So when the technology gets good enough that we don't need actors at all, well, what are these people going to do? Are they planning for a future when there are no actors? Are they? No. They're trying to do everything they can to stop everybody from doing this kind of thing. And making it expensive and passing laws to prevent everybody from doing things. That's what they do. They don't want change. They want to keep ripping you off like they were in the 80s with, you know, all the movies and TV and everything where before the VHS tapes, you had to watch TV, right? So they could get you right there, right? And they've slowly been losing control ever since. And now, I'm sitting on the Unreal Engine, I have no streaming services. I have none of this shit. I have video games I like to enjoy. I get value from these games where there's replayability, okay? And I don't have to worry about that's identity politics, being politically correct, any of this kind of crap. Because why? Because I'm not engaging with people that are going to whine about it. Okay? Most of the people that are subscribed to me too are very loyal, and I appreciate you. You know, sticking by me through this, you know, these hard times. And we'll get there. You know, I mean, I'm not rich, so I'm buying things one piece at a time, as Johnny Cash would say. Yes, yes, yes. Anyway, and I would suggest, you want to see an artist who crosses the boundaries of politics and everything else, and it talks about stuff that's even relevant today, go listen to that guy. You'll find some stuff of his on YouTube. Anyway. And I even saw some black guy listening to his music, and he's going, holy shit, this guy's pretty deep. And I said, you know, you'd be surprised how many artists he wrote music for. Of all races and genders and colors and whatever. Okay? A talented person doesn't give a shit about these things. Okay? He's more about the creativity that flows from himself. Okay? That's the difference between me and other people, let's say. We had this discussion about this Gina Carano. She basically, in a nutshell, says that, okay, the neighbors of these Jews and were going around throwing rocks at the Jews, and it wasn't the soldiers that were hurting them. Like, excuse me? What the flying hell? That's why she got fired, eh? It's basically like saying, oh, the 6 million Jews that they tricked into these big trains and shipped them off to get put in ovens and you know, gas chambers. That was, you know, they, for, you know, lovey-dovey time, right? I mean, in a 2.5-3 year span, they killed over 6 million of them, or more, roughly. Okay, I'd be like, let's try that with Americans. Okay, we're just gonna load randomly pick 2 million Americans a year for the next 3 years, load you onto some trains, and just that's it. Okay, we'll take your stuff, we'll take your items, and it's now the states, okay, to distribute how it wants. Yeah. And here's a tip for you. If you're working for somebody's company who was founded by a Jewish guy, I would probably think it's wise not to be sitting there yapping about Jewish shit in World War II at all, period. No matter what side you think you're on, okay? That just shows how stupid this woman was, okay? I'd be like, okay. If I work for a Polish company, I really shouldn't be making Polish jokes all day, should I? Because somebody's going to be offended, and sooner or later they'll find a reason to get rid of you. Holy balls, eh? Stupid. Just stupid. You know. And then this one guy in a Discord chat was trying to find reasons to justify or, you know, oh, it was a typo. What the... wasn't a typo, it came from someone else's Instagram, and she just copied it and didn't put any context there. In other words, saying, I agree with this. That's what that statement means, okay? If you don't say, look what this jerk posted, and then you post it, you're on the jerk side. I just go, whoa, man, that's trippy shit. Let's have some more guys. Let's have a big lift. I'm not done yet. There's the Lochner armor. Level 1 legendary. You get it on your other class, and what you do is, want to start over another class just for some fun, go up over here, I'll show you this little tip.
safe storage. No
click
questions.
Here, see this little button here? Click here, you got all this stuff in here. That's how I get a whole bunch of these brought over here, right? From the other characters, just massacre things. And then it lets this guy level a little quicker and stuff. He's not as strong as the other guys, however, he's getting there, okay? And it's not a bad build. I mean, it's basically an undead build, right? And it's vitality and physical, right? So, it's fun. Where am I at here? Secure the portal. Okay. Anyway. So I found out, also, this other Windows 10 PC, the AMD FX 6300, 6-core PC, only has 3 logical cores. Or no, 3 cores, and 6 of them are these pretend logical ones, but the problem is most games, PC, and software don't recognize the 3 extra cores. So while I'm sitting there trying to do things, it is faster per shader worker, and actually is about as fast as its dual-core, 4-threaded Intel machine. And just a little bit faster, and it's using half the, or 50% of the shaders. I better do this with doing that. There we go. Anyway, what am I doing here? Oh yeah. Went for a little walk. Let's see, what else we got around here? Yeah, we're going across the bridge here. Come on. Anyway. Yeah, I gotta go up this way. Come on. Oh, here we go. Got him, boys. Got him. The other thing about the Lochnar set gives you lots of extra XP. So it's like a leveling thing. Wow. That's a lot of shit, man. Two classes in Dawn of Masteries, so the combinations is, I don't know, you do the math, I got things to do, you know what I mean? Here we go. Oh, okay, so, I actually want to go back here, because there's that little cave I want to go in. Come on, buddy, go across the bridge instead of standing there. That's what I hate about these games, man. It's all stupid that way. Yeah. I don't know if there's a devotion point in here, but we'll find out. So I turned up the I turned up the hero thing. The epic coins more. This time around, I put up the density, which has these guys on it, more of these guys, and I'm getting more XP this way in a kind of long run because I'm able to actually progress. It's too much of a long fight, you know, the hero adding up. Okay, there we go, yeah. I don't know what's up here. Come on. No. Oh. guys are good fighters, too. Yeah, I'll win. That's for sure. Good cannon fodder, though. There's the exit. Came out of this one cave and there's like 50 heroes in it, and I spent the next half an hour running around in circles and going back and in and out of the cave to heal my guys until I killed them all. It was like the amount of time it took to do that, you're better off not doing it and just keeping your sort of where it should be. Come on, boys, one at a time. Now back over here, here comes the level. Above, do some more up here. Yeah, there's a boss. Got dynamite, so I can do that special area. Okay. skeletons are like little skeleton mages. So what's that do? Okay, so let me think here. What's this thing do right now? Engineering's life. Talent of decay. Plan over there. Maxed out there. I didn't even have those skills on either. This. Or that. Or that. Ooh, I summoned three at one. Two at a time. Thank you. cool, boys. We'll go over here and beat people up. Get that little spot. Yeah. Gotta kill everything. XP is XP. Alright. Not this way. Up and over. Kill it before I even get to it. Nice. Alright. Exit, boys. We're not done yet. We're gonna go to another area. Do it too. So I think I got a skeleton from somewhere, right? Do I? Maybe. Do the rest of the map. It'll tell me if I do something. Clearing down. Okay. I see numpkies. Time to die. Oh. love not needing healing potions. Okay, that's for that area, right? So I was gonna do this. Alright, replace that ring there. Because it'll add damage, but I lose defensive. But again, pets gain health and damage. But so, not sure what bone graft is. So I'll have to do some more building on it. It's a bit of fun though. A little less work when you let them do the fighting for you. So get this area over in the corner. And where do I go? Come on, get up over here, break the wall down. Let's go. There we are. Get you guys on the outside. Be doing some Stellaris and Total War Warhammer 2 stuff coming up. I also now have Rome Total War 2, so I might get into that with some mods and stuff too. So we'll see.
Time. Oh, hello, traveler.
Guys, have a good one.